This is diode and zener diode characteristic strainer. Order code of this strainer is 36152. These are the two digital panel meters which are provided for measurement of voltmeter and current meter. This is the current meter and this is a voltmeter, DC voltmeter. This is dual range voltmeter. First range of this voltmeter is 2 volt and second range is 20 volt. With the help of this toggle switch, you can select the range of this voltmeter. When you put this switch to upper position, that is 2 volt, full deflection of this voltmeter is 2 volt and this is 20 volt range. When you put this toggle switch to lower position, this voltmeter reads up to 20 volt DC. And this is the DC ammeter range. This is also dual range current meter. First range of this current meter is 20 microampere. Second range of this current meter is 20 milliampere. And you can select the range with the help of this toggle switch by putting this to 20 microampere or to 20 milliampere. These are the two input terminals for this voltmeter. This is positive terminal of this voltmeter, this is negative terminal, and this is again two terminals for this current meter. This is positive and this is negative terminal of this voltmeter. This is regulated power supply block. This is variable power supply, 0 to 10 volt range of this supply, and this is the symbol of this supply, and this is the current limiting resistance, series resistance, which is internally connected with this supply. This is the output terminal. This is positive terminal and this is negative terminal. These are the two semiconductor diode which are provided on this panel for the different experiment and different characteristic to study the characteristics of these semiconductor diodes. This is OS79 diode and this is Zener diode for the study of Zener diode characteristic, and this is the diode for study of semiconductor diode, germanium diode. This is germanium diode. So this is your power on off switch. You can switch on the main supply to the trainer with the help of this switch. So now let's start with object first. Object first is to study and plot the forward and reverse bias characteristics of a germanium semiconductor diode. So for this object, figure first A, this is your figure first A. This is the circuit for forward biasing of a diode and this is the circuit for reverse biasing of a diode. This is figure first B. So with the help of these circuits, we make the connections with the help of page codes. And the procedure for this experiment is given in our manual. So according to the procedure, assemble the circuit of figure first. Keep the 0 to 10 volt supply output at minimum position with the help of this knob. You can increase or decrease the supply voltage of this supply, power supply, variable power supply. So put this knob to minimum position. Fully anti-clockwise position is minimum position, and switch on the supply after assemble the circuit. So first we have to assemble the circuit. So this is the positive terminal and this is the circuit diagram for this experiment. This is series resistance which is internally connected for the limiting of the current, and this is positive terminal of the supply which is connected to positive terminal of milliampere, and this is the milliampere meter. When you put this switch to milliampere range, this current meter range is now 20 milliampere range. So connect this positive output terminal of power supply to positive input terminal of current meter, and this is the negative terminal of current meter, which is connected to anode of a diode OA79. This is negative terminal, and this is the anode of this OA79 diode. So we have connected this negative terminal to anode of this OA79 diode, and this is the cathode of this OA79 diode. And according to the circuit, this negative terminal of this, cathode terminal of this diode is connected to negative terminal of this power supply, and this is the cathode which is connected to negative terminal of this power supply. Now this is, this circuit is completed. This is the voltmeter with the range of 2 volt, and voltmeter is connected across the diode. So now we are going to connect this voltmeter across the diode, and positive terminal of this diode is connected to anode of positive terminal of this voltmeter is connected to anode of the diode. So this is the positive terminal of this voltmeter. When you put this switch to 2 volt position, range of this DC voltmeter is now 2 volt, and positive terminal of this voltmeter is connected to anode. This is the anode terminal of this diode, and negative terminal of this diode is connected to cathode of this diode or negative terminal of this power supply. So we can connect it to cathode terminal or negative terminal of the power supply, and this is cathode. So we have connected this negative terminal of voltmeter to the cathode of OA79 diode. Now your circuit is completed. Now your connections are completed according to the circuit diagram, which is provided in our manual as figure 1A. So now follow the procedure for this experiment first, and according to the procedure, switch on the supply to the board. Now this is mains power, which is on. Slowly increase the 0 to 10 volt supply and take readings of diode current at various voltage settings up to about 1.5 volt or less. So take the different readings with the help of this supply variable knob. Say this is 0.1 volt reading, and this is the reading of your current meter. So note down the reading of V. This is V and this is I. So V is now 0.1 volt DC, and I is, current is 0.08 milliampere, and this is the reading at 0.2 volt DC. This is the voltmeter. This is the reading of V. V is now 0.2 volt DC, and this is the current reading, which is 0.43 milliampere. So you can take the various readings, various voltage readings and various current readings with the help of these two meters. Increase the power supply up to about 1.5 volt, and this is the reading of 0.3 volt DC, and this is the current reading at this voltage, and this is 0.4, and this is the current reading, this is 0.5. note down the current meter reading at this voltage. This is 0.6,
This is 0.7. Note down the current reading at various voltages settings, and this is the reading of 0.8. Remember that the range of this current meter is 20 milliampere, and your at this time your current is 16.3 milliampere. So don't increase the power supply. Such a way that current exceeds the limit of this current meter, and this is the limit of this current meter. This is 0.88 volt DC, and at this voltage reading current is now 19.68 milliampere, and this is the approximately last limit of this current meter. So don't increase the power supply. And note down the various readings with the help of these two meters. We observe, plot the voltage and current readings on a graph paper by taking voltage on the x-axis and current on the y-axis. The plot will look like the forward bias characteristic, which is shown in figure 1C. So figure 1C is given in our manual, and this is your figure 1C. This is your figure 1C, and this is the characteristic curve of forward biased diode, and this is the volts, this is current, and your curve. Characteristic curves will look like this graph. We observe from the above characteristics that a forward voltage of about 0.2 volt is required before the diode start conduction. So this is your experiment of forward bias characteristics. Now for reverse bias characteristics, switch off the trainer and remove all previous connections. And follow the procedure for this object, reverse bias characteristics of a semiconductor diode, germanium semiconductor diode. Switch off the supply to the trainer and reverse the connection of the diode as per figure 1B. So figure 1B is given in our manual, and this is your figure 1B. So with the help of this figure, we are going to make a circuit with the help of these page codes. This is the series resistance, which is internally connected, and this is the open end, other end of this series resistance, which is available on the panel. This is positive terminal, and positive terminal of this power supply is connected to positive input terminal of current meter, and this is positive and connected to positive terminal of current meter, and this is negative terminal. And according to the diagram, negative terminal is connected to cathode of OA79, and this is cathode of OA79. Anode of this OA79 is connected to negative terminal of power supply, variable power supply. This is anode terminal, which is connected to negative terminal of this variable power supply. And this is the voltmeter, which is connected to across the variable power supply, and positive, this is positive terminal, which is connected to positive input terminal of this voltmeter, and This is the negative terminal which is connected to negative terminal of this voltmeter. Now your voltmeter is connected to the across of this variable power supply, and this is the range of this voltmeter. When you put this switch to 20 volt, now your DC voltmeter is the 20 volt range voltmeter, and this is the milliampere meter. So first set it to 20 microampere range and switch on the trainer and follow the procedure. Slowly increase the 0 to 10 volt supply. Note down the readings of current meter for various voltage settings up to 10 volt. So slowly increase this input supply voltage with the help of this knob and note down the different readings. This is 0.09, this is 0.1 volt, and this is the current at this 0.1 volt DC voltage. This is 0.2 volt, and this is the current meter reading at this voltage. This is, at this time, this current meter is 20 microampere range and current is approximately 18 microampere for above current meter readings. Put this switch to 20 milliampere and note down the reading of this current meter. This is 0.3. For the 0.3 volt, current reading is 0.07 milliampere. This is 0.4 volt, and the reading of current meter is 0.08 milliampere. For the graphical presentation of this current, you can convert the milliampere to microampere or microampere to milliampere for the same scale on your graph paper. So note down the reading of current with the help of this current meter by putting the switch to proper range settings, and this is the 0.5 volt, and this is the current meter readings 0.1 milliampere. This is 1 volt, and at the 1 volt 0.16 milliampere is current, and this is your 2 volt and current is 0.26 milliampere. You can take various readings with the help of this variable power supply knob up to 10 volt, and this is your 10 volt, and at this volt current is 0.89 approximate milliampere, 0.89 milliampere. Plot the above readings on the same graph sheet by extending the XY axis on the same graph sheet. This was the forward biased characteristic curve, and by extending this axis to minus side and this axis to minus side, you can plot the reverse biased graph with the help of these readings which you have taken in this experiment, second experiment, with the help of these two meters. The plot will look like the one shown as reverse bias characteristic in figure 1c. We observe that very little reverse current called leakage current flows through the diode in the reverse bias mode. For the OA79 diode, this leakage current will vary from piece to piece and will be up to around 20 microampere. This leakage current is too little for silicon signal diodes. So leakage current will vary from piece to piece, so remember that for the experiment on different tenors. Your object 2 is to study and plot the forward and reverse bias breakdown characteristics of a Zener diode. So for the Zener diode experiments, circuit diagram are provided in our manual, and circuit diagram is figure 2a for forward bias characteristics, and figure 2b is for reverse bias characteristics of a Zener diode. So assemble the circuit of figure 2a, and this is the figure of 2a for Zener diode forward biasing characteristics. So assemble the circuit with the help of the circuit diagram, and this is your positive terminal of power supply after the series resistance, and this is the positive terminal of current meter. The range of this current meter is 20 milliampere. By putting the switch to 20 milliampere side, you can measure the current up to 20 milliampere with the help of this current meter, and this is negative terminal and which is connected to Zener diode anode terminal. You can use the red lead for the better presentation of your connections. This is your Zener diode. 6V8 means this is the breakdown voltage of this Zener diode, 6.8 volt breakdown voltage, and connect this negative lead to anode terminal of this Zener diode, and this is the cathode terminal of this Zener diode, and according to the circuit diagram, this is connected to negative supply of negative terminal of variable power supply, and this is the voltmeter which is connected to across the Zener diode, and positive terminal of this voltmeter is connected to anode of this Zener diode, and negative terminal is connected to cathode of this Zener diode, and this is the negative terminal, and this is the cathode terminal of this Zener diode. So now your circuit is completed according to this diagram. Now we should follow the procedure, and according to the procedure, switch on the supply to the board, switch on the supply, slowly increase the 0 to 10 volt supply, and take readings of current through the Zener diode for various voltage settings. And this is your voltage reading and this is your current reading. So note down the this is 0.6 volt and at this voltage, this is the current readings. This is 0.7 volt, forward bias voltage 0.7, and at this voltage, current is 0.99 milliampere. And this is the current reading at 0.8. Don't increase the voltage because current meter exceeds the range of 20 milliampere. So you can take the different readings from 0.1, this is 0.1, this is 0.2, this is 0.3, this is 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.63, 0.64, 0.65, 0.67, 0.68, and this is 0.7, 0.73, 0.75, 0.77, 0.78, 0.79, 0.78, up to 0.78 voltage, the safe range for this current meter. So up to 0.78 volt range is the safe range for this current meter. So note down the various readings of voltmeter and current meter. Plot the readings on a graph paper and take various voltages on x-axis and current on y-axis. The plot will look like the forward characteristics shown in figure 2C. Figure 2C is provided. This is figure 2C and this is the graphical presentation of volt and current as a forward biased Zener diode. So with the help of different readings you can draw the characteristic curves of forward biasing of a diode, Zener diode. You can plot the characteristic curve with the help of these readings. We observe that Zener diode when forward biased exhibits the characteristics of a silicon general purpose diode. Here about 0.6 volt of forward voltage is required before the Zener diode starts conduction. So you can study the different forward biasing of a Zener diode, forward biasing of a Zener diode. And now we are going to reverse bias characteristics of this diode, Zener diode. Switch off the supply to the trainer and reverse the connection of the Zener diode as figure 2B. And according to the figure 2B, this is your figure 2B. And in this figure, voltmeter is connected to across the power supply and polarity of Zener diode, biasing of Zener diode is opposite, is in opposite direction. Negative of this power supply is connected to anode of this Zener diode and this is the positive terminal. And this is current meter, and another point of this current meter, negative point of this current meter is connected to According to the diagram, this is connected to cathode terminal of this diode. So now we have connected this negative terminal of this current meter to cathode terminal of this zener diode. Voltmeter is connected across the variable power supply, positive to positive and negative terminal to negative terminal. Now your voltmeter is connected to across the power supply. Put this variable knob to minimum position. Fully anticlockwise position is minimum position of this knob of this power supply. Switch on the board and slowly increase the 0 to 10 volt and note down the readings of current through zener diode at various settings. Switch on the trainer. Slowly increase the 0 to 10 volt supply and note down the current reading. This is your 1 volt and this is the current reading. This is 0 at this 1 volt reading. And this is 2 volt and at this 2 volt current is 0. This is the reading of 3 volt. Current reading 0. This is 4 volt, 5, 6. Now current meter reads 6, 6.2, 6.3, 6.4, 6.5, and current reading at this voltage is 0.02 milliampere. This is 6.6, and current meter is 0.15 milliampere, and this is 6.7, and current meter reads 6 milliampere, and this is the breakdown voltage, inner breakdown voltage 6.8 approximate, and current reading is 12.85 milliampere. Don't increase the voltage because current meter exceeds the limit of 20 milliampere range. So you should not increase the input voltage such a way that current meter exceeds the limit of 20 milliampere range. Plot the readings on the same graph sheet by extending the axis on the negative side. The plot will look like the reverse bias characteristics, which is shown in figure 2C. This is your figure 2C, reverse bias characteristics, and this is the axis which is extended to negative side, and this axis is extended to also in negative sides, and this is the reverse biased characteristics curve. So with the help of various readings, you can plot this graph on same graph paper sheets. We observe that negligible current flows through the zener diode till the zener voltage, that is 6.8 in this case, is reached. Thereafter, on increasing the applied voltage, there is almost no variation in the voltage across the zener diode. So after 6.8, This is 6.8. So this is the experiments on germanium semiconductor diode and Zener diode. These are the different experiments of reverse biasing, forward biasing of germanium semiconductor diode and Zener diode. With the help of this trainer, trainer is diode and Zener diode characteristics trainer, and the order code of this trainer is 36152. Thank you.